Starting goaltenders tonight for the St. Thomas Tommies, they will go with Justin Collier in goal. It's a rookie season for the St. Thomas netminder, and he comes in having played three games in the first half, a 3.96 goals against average, a save percentage, 879, a win, and no losses on the year. The Acadia Axemen will go with the gentleman that carried the load in the first half. Evan Mosier will start tonight, played in 12 games in the first half, 2.86 goals against average, his save percentage 891, 7 wins and 5 losses on the season. And so we're set to get things underway here in Wolfville. The Axemen in their reds and St. Thomas in the whites, and play is underway as the puck goes into the Acadia zone, and going back for it is Ward. In behind the Acadia net, plays it to the corner for Gibbons, and the defenseman moves it out on the right side. A high pass that Chouinard couldn't knock down. Schmidia will fire it back into the Axemen zone, and Mosier will leave it behind the goal for Gibbons. Banking it off the boards, hopping by everybody, and sliding back to the St. Thomas line. Poulin is there. He'll snap it off the boards, goes high in the air, into the bench. Travis Young with me, as I mentioned a few minutes ago. I would think, Travis, when you have 4 weeks layoff, chance to go home with friends, a little extra turkey, it's probably not an easy thing to get back into the swing of it.
No, I mean, I think it's nice. The guys have, you know, been in town for a couple days here and had a chance to, you know, get on the ice a few times. But, you know, the first game's always tough. And, you know, that's the nice thing about having these two exhibition games is, you know, give the guys a chance to kind of get their legs back and get back into game shape here.
Cullen Warren, who was hurt in the first half, back in the lineup, and he fires a pass through the middle into the St. Thomas zone. And on the far side, the Axemen try to establish something. Clark in front. Great save by Collier as the puck goes into the corner. Clark behind the net. Clark in the right wing corner, looking back toward the point, hangs onto it. Now he'll dish it back to Dietrich, another Axemen that was hurt for a considerable amount of time in the first half, back in the lineup. Puck at the point, kept in, and it rolls in behind the St. Thomas net. Puck over on the far side, and a chance for the St. Thomas Tommies to move it out. And going back for it is Hennigan, and he'll play it to Andrasopoulos in behind the net. Andrasopoulos, the veteran defenseman, looks through the middle. High pass knocked down by Gaynor at the Acadia line. And Gaynor, who got off to a great offensive start this year, in fact has a hat trick for the Axemen. Defense takes over more and will play it deep into his own end. And back there is Owens to move it ahead. And Jezegu brings it in on the left side for Acadia to the goal line. Centering pass through the crease. And now it's knocked out by the Tommies. And Scott will just leave it. And it's brought ahead by Reich with a long shot stopped by Mosier. And the rebound toward the side of the net kept in by St. Thomas. Now the puck in behind the Acadia goal. And Brown from Wolfville, Nova Scotia, along the near boards, pinned up by Maine. Puck is kept in at the point, shot went off a leg, well wide of the goal. Jezegu will bounce it off the boards, out to center, and it's fired right back in by Eric Tremblay. Both teams making some changes, just over 2 minutes played in the opening period. Kurseba for Acadia in behind the goal, and McElraith will carry it around. Leaves it for Kurseba. Now he'll play it to the near side, and it's brought up by Gurman, John Gurman. A rookie forward for the Axemen plays it behind the net for McElraith. Centering pass comes to the point. Ward bobbled it, gets it back, moves down the left side, and then he's poke-checked by Poulin, and St. Thomas will take over. Long pass over on the left wing side, and the Tommies get control. McIntyre slowed the play up in the neutral ice area for Acadia, now makes his way off the ice. Poulin with a lead pass to Sanza in over the line, but the play offside. And Randy Cameron offside. Well, this St. Thomas team, Travis, in the first half, I think surprised a few people. They're in seventh place right now, but 3 wins, 9 losses, a couple of overtime losses, and I think they've played better than what some expected.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, they're, you know, they've been, I think, probably in every game they've played. I mean, I think going into the year, I think a lot of people thought they were going to, you know, kind of struggle and maybe, you know, have a few blowouts, but they've really done a real good job of keeping games tight and getting some big points in the first half.
Well, they're only 5 points out of a playoff position behind the St. Evex Expen with the last playoff spot. The Expen with 13 points. Acadia will see them on Monday in their second and final exhibition game. Acadia coming into this game, by the way, in fourth place, 19 points, just 4 points out of first place, and a log jam at the top of the standings. Morin at center, giving it to Jonathan LeBaire. He'll play it back to the Acadia defense. Puck over to Gibbons, and Gibbons ahead to LaBerge. LaBerge through the middle, turns it over, and St. Thomas will bring it back in. Morehouse, a newcomer, long shot that's stopped by Mosier. And now the Axemen get control, and Chouinard tries to pass through the middle. Morin has it and skates, gives it back to Chouinard, in over the line, moves to the boards, and loses control of the puck, and the Tommies will bounce it down the ice. Morehouse, the newcomer for St. Thomas, giving chase, gets to the corner. His teammates changing up. He falls to the ice after being hit by Morin. And now the puck rolls to center. Trombley's going to fire it back in. And it'll be brought out by Gibbons to center. Gibbons gets to the puck at the St. Thomas line. Gibbons, backhand pass in front, knocked down by Trombley. Scott for St. Thomas controlling it. And the Tommies move ahead. Reich out at center. In over the line, makes a couple of moves. Then he's poke-checked there, and Clark has it for Acadia. And Clark, the leading scorer, had the puck knocked off his stick. Back into the Axemen zone, Kurseba. 4 minutes, 20 seconds gone in the opening period. Both teams with a couple of shots here, but nothing spectacular here through 4.5 minutes of play, as both of these teams haven't seen the ice in terms of playing games in a month. Puck goes into the St. Thomas zone. The goaltender will fire it around. It's banked off the boards, and here come the Tommies, but over-skating the puck on the far side was Sanza, or else a odd man rush was shaping up for St. Thomas. Dietrich, left side with a slap shot off the stick of Collier, over the glass and out of play. Well, as I mentioned, the regular season, Atlantic University's Ford Hockey will open up a week from tonight, January the 6th. Acadia takes on the Moncton Aigle Blue in Wolfville to open up the second half of the season. Another team that has done very well, 10 wins and 4 losses in the first half. Off the faceoff, Tommy's control, working it around the boards. Cameron can't get it by Ward. They battle along the blue line. Now it slides out to center. Bona is there, and he'll just lob it back into the St. Thomas zone. Puck played around the boards by Bernier. Tommy's come out, long lead pass for Sanza, missed him. Back forward is Bona, plays it behind the net, coughed it up. Sanza in front, and he missed his intended receiver. And back the other way goes Jezegu with a left wing pass to Brown. Brown with a shot that deflects over the glass, and we'll get a stoppage here with 14:36. Well, Travis, think it's safe to say right now you can see that there's some rusty on both sides of the ice.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I don't think, you know, I think you have that bit of a layoff. You know, passing is probably the one thing that really goes for sure, and, you know, we've seen that a lot here in the first, you know, 5.5 minutes is just, you know, either errant passes or when guys do make the pass, you know, they seem to be bobbling it and turning the puck over quite a bit.
McIntyre for Acadia. Plays it to McElraith. McElraith gives it to Bona, working down the left side, but he didn't pick it up cleanly. Puck at the blue line kept in. Now the Tommies will move it out. Puck is bounced off the boards, and it'll go down the ice for an icing call here against the St. Thomas Tommies. The Axemen with 3 shots on goal and St. Thomas with 2, but neither goaltender really has been tested here for the first 5 minutes and 42 seconds. Faceoff in the Stu zone, off the draw, Axemen control. Eckelman back at the blue line, plays it to the point. Morin with a shot, just sails wide of the net. German plays it to McIntyre. He shoots up high, Collier the stop, juggles it, and they battle away in the blue paint for it, and now we'll get a whistle. Well, you may have noticed Eckelman playing the left point, and a bit of an experiment going on here. Of course, Travis, in the first half, the Acadia defense really pummeled by injuries. Jenner's out for a while yet, and I think right now a bit of a test here in case you have to move guys back.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I think, you know, you look probably the last 6, 7, 8 games, you were playing with 4 or 5 defensemen, you know, at the best of times, and obviously, you know, something where you need a guy who, you know, if the situation does arise in the second half or in the playoffs, that you want somebody back there who's comfortable and knows what they're doing. So, you know, giving Dusty a chance here just to, you know, get some reps back there and then see if, you know, he may be the guy that can do that.
Tommy's controlling pass is picked off, and now Helis moves into the St. Thomas zone, and he's forced to center it, and it went off a stick into the corner. Helis, who had a good rookie campaign in the first half, now a penalty coming up to St. Thomas as LaBerge was hit from behind, and he is getting up slowly. And so the Axemen are going to get a power play, and now Helis went over to have something to say to Trombley, and Trombley got a stick up around the chin of Helis, and there may be additional penalties handed out here. And LaBerge up on his own and making his way slowly toward the Acadia bench. And so Tremblay is going to go to the penalty box here for St. Thomas. And I'm just wondering if he may have picked up an additional two. No, they put 2 minutes up on the board. So Tremblay goes into the box. A fifth-year defenseman from Gatineau, Quebec. Gila shoots quickly. Collier looked behind him. Puck is whipped around the boards and kept in by Clark at the right point. LaBerge on the right wing boards. Plays it to the point for Clark. He'll give it to Owens. Owens back to Clark. The LaBerge line shoots, and it's stopped. And Ward has it behind the net. Ward behind the St. Thomas goal, looking out front. Plays it over to LaBerge. Quickly back to Clark. Shot on the way up high, off the post and around the boards. The Axemen come close to opening the scoring. Chance for Maine to bank it off the boards. He does, and the puck rolls into the Acadia zone as the Tommies change up their penalty killers. Minute 20 to go on the man advantage for the Axemen. No score in the game. Here in the first period, Helis down the right side, plays the puck back. Clark will pick it up inside the blue line, gives it to Owens. Owens firing it over. Clark sends it down into the corner. Alex Beaton along the right wing boards to the point for Clark. Clark to Owens at the left point. Sends it cross ice looking for Beaton, but it's off a St. Thomas stick outside the line, and the Axemen retreat. Warren has it at center, finds a little bit of space, brings it in, and Ward on the left wing side works toward the corner, and he was worked off the puck by Andrusopoulos, kept in by the Axemen, puck to the corner, and Helis has it to the point for Gibbons, back to Helis, to the circle, his pass off a skate, and it bounces, Tommy's with a chance, and it's knocked down the ice. 25 seconds to go on the man advantage for Acadia. And Gibbons, the rookie defenseman in behind the goal, leaves it for Jezegu. And Jezegu comes out to center, leaves it for Gibbons. Return pass, Jezegu didn't pick it up cleanly. And the Tommies fire it down the ice. And that's going to do it. Mosier out of his goal to give it to the defense. And the penalty is over, and the Axemen fail to score with a man advantage. Beaton works the puck over on the right side, and Chouinard circling at center, trying to find room. Chouinard now picks it up, moves in over the line. Shot blocked. And the rebound taken and not clear. Jezegu has it into the slot. Tried to get a shot away. There's a weak shot by McIlwraith, steered away by Collier. McIlwraith takes a bump from Shermidiev. Puck to the point. Gibbons has it. Gibbons, the backhander, goes high and wide of the goal. Gibbons after it. Penalty coming up to Shermidiev as Gibbons was taken down. And the Axemen are going to get their second straight power play opportunity with just under 11 minutes to play. And at times, that first power play, Travis, didn't look too bad, but a little shaky. But in fairness to both of these teams here, we've talked about the rust, and that's going to happen.
Yeah, I mean, I thought early on, you guys did a good job moving the puck and, you know, kind of keeping things simple and getting pucks to the net. And I thought, as the power play dragged on there, probably trying to, force some plays through the box that really weren't there, especially, this early when you're just coming back. You really want to simplify things and get as many pucks to the net as you can.
Owens cross ice with pass to Clark. His shot is blocked by McDonald. Clark whips it down to Ward. Side of the net. Out front. Owens shoots. Scores. Great patience in the high slot by Owens. And he just made a little move to his left and fired the shot up high. And Christopher Owens picks up where he left off in the first half. Owens with 9 goals as a defenseman in 15 games in the first half of the season. And although this one won't count as far as his 2011-12 stats, Travis, this guy's picked up right where he left off in December.
Yeah, I mean, he probably one of the, if not the top player, one of the top players for sure in the league in that first half. And, nice to see him get off to a good start here, even just in the exhibition season.
1-0, Acadia leads here midway through the opening period on the goal by Owens. Puck centered out in front of the Acadia net, taken away by McIlwraith and ripped around the boards, kept in by Poulin with a shot toward the net. Deflects, hit the goalpost, or maybe the crossbar. And the St. Thomas forward was down low and got a stick on it and deflected it up high, and the Axemen were lucky there. Puck deflects outside the Axemen line. It's going to be fired back in by Bernier. St. Thomas changing up. And Kurseba with time, and Kurseba backtracks into his own end. Cross ice to Bona. We've hit the midway point of period number one, with Acadia leading 1-0. Puck up to the Acadia line. Gallant mistaking a pass. Eckelman playing defense, banks it off the boards. Cullen Morin sends it out to Dietrich, and he didn't pick it up cleanly. Now Morin will bring it out. The Axemen defenseman who missed a lot of time with a shot that went off a leg. Dietrich on the near side battling. Puck comes to the line and an offside call against the Acadia Axemen. So Owens with the power play goal here. And the Axemen score on their seventh shot of the opening period to make it a 1-0 lead. There's 9 minutes and 35 seconds remaining in period number one. Gaynor will take the faceoff outside the St. Thomas line. Tommy's control, Andrasopoulos working it ahead to Scott, and they wave off the icing. Behind the net is Evan Mosier, and the goaltender tried to fire it around the boards, hit a St. Thomas player. Reich has it in the corner, banks it into the corner for Scott. Eckelman is there for Acadia. He'll play it over to Brown, and Brown with a lead pass looking for Gaynor. Missed him. Eckelman gets it back. Gives to Dietrich, and he'll just dump it into the St. Thomas zone. Gaynor gets to the puck, hit by Andrasopoulos, and then Gaynor went flying to the ice. And the Tommies move out to center. Puck on the far side, and Bonneau has a pass deflect and goes high over the glass and out of play. The faceoff will stay in the Acadia zone. Nice to see some bodies back in the lineup. I know we talked about the injuries. Jenner really the only guy that was a regular in the first half, and but just nice to see some names there you haven't seen for a while.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, obviously, you know, Jenner and Ridgeway both being out, but, you know, to get, you know, Dietrich and Morin and some of those guys who missed, you know, huge portions of that first half, and to actually be able to ice a full lineup's, you know, a nice feeling for sure.
Ridgeway, a rookie, out with a concussion, and no timetable as to his return. And any time you talk about concussions, really there's no set time, as we've heard a lot about in the past few months. Puck comes up to the Acadia line, bounces by some Tommies, and the Axemen take over. Ward with control for the Axemen, fires it up on the right side, a little too far for Schwenard. Ward gets to the puck, now plays it back to Gibbons. Quick pass out to Schwenard. Schwenard around one man, in over the line on the left side, drops it off. Gibbons in, shoots, and it's blocked. Rebound fired by Clark. He didn't get a lot on it. Collier, though, in the right place and is able to make the save. With 8:03 remaining here in period number one. As I mentioned earlier in the game, the Axemen will play an exhibition game Monday against St. Evex in Berwick. By the way, if you're in the Valley and looking for tickets, they're available at the Kings Mutual Century Center all weekend from Berwick minor hockey players and members, and they will be sold at the door as well. Clark behind the net. To the corner for Dietrich, to Clark. Clark out to Dietrich, walks in, shoot stopped by Collier. He was in a little deep, maybe had a little more time to come out in front. Puck down the ice into the Acadia zone. Bona battling there, now the puck to the corner. And Dietrich picks it up, and he's able to slide it up on the boards into the St. Thomas zone. Beaton looking for it. And it's dumped around the boards by the Tommies. Trombley firing it to center. Owens has it. He has the game's only goal. Gives to Clark, left side. Wine shoots, and it deflects over the glass and out of play. The shot's 8-3 at this point. The Axemen have done a good job of not allowing the Tommies to get anywhere close to Evan Mosier, who really hasn't been tested here. Face off in the St. Thomas zone. McElraith will take the draw, and the Tommies don't line up properly, so they'll wave Reich out of the faceoff circle. And Bonneau comes in and wins the draw. Puck fired around the boards, and it gets by Cullen Moore and down the ice. Eckelman's after it, banking it off the boards. And Gurman couldn't clear it out. Eckelman gets it back, fires a pass over to Morin, and he saucers one through the middle that went off somebody out at center, back into the St. Thomas zone. Hennigan is there. Partially knocked off the puck, but Andrasopoulos has it for St. Thomas. Works up the far side and dumps it around the boards. Cullen Morin lets the puck go by, and Jesse McIntyre on the near boards battling. Scott with a long shot and an easy stop by Mosier as he deflects it over the glass and out of play. 6:36 remaining here in period number one. The Axemen up 1-0. If you're listening online, hope you're enjoying it. Both teams sending out some fresh troops here. Gaynor out to take the draw. Gaynor scored his hat trick against St. Thomas in Fredericton early in the season. Kurseba with the puck deep in the Axemen zone. Banks it off the boards, out to Brown. Quickly ahead to Jezegu. Jezegu sends across ice and Ward misfired as he wanted to one-time it from the right wing circle. A left-handed shot. Long pass that's blocked by Gaynor, deflects into the Axemen zone, and Gaynor will pick it up and moves it ahead to Brown. Casey Brown sending it ahead to Ward, and Ward on the left side. Works it in around the boards. After it is Poulin, takes a hit from Jezegu. Jezegu will send it back to the point. Kurseba with it. Winds up, slap shot, and it hit his own man in front. And the puck dumped down, and here's a breakaway opportunity for Sanza. Way out of his net is Evan Mosier to stop him. Mosier's trying to get back in. Shot through the crease by Sanza, and he missed as he put it through the blue paint, looking at an open net. A dangerous play by Mosier, but he was able to get out and just foil Sanza enough to break up the play. Puck into the Axemen zone. Puck dumped around the boards. Shot by Main is blocked, and now Schwenard with it. Schwenard battling on the near side. McDonald will play it back into the St. Thomas zone. 5:20 to go on the first. Tremblay's pass. Picked up off the boards by Zambique, and then he slowed up by Bona, who had him lined up inside the Acadia blue line. Puck centered out in front. Quick shot. Stopped by Mosier's side of the net. Tommy's here trying to get something going. Puck is centered out in front, but the Axemen break it up. And Schwenard quickly out on the right side. Four Axemen across the blue line. Tries to play it ahead for Clark, and it slides right down to the goaltender Collier, and he's going to hang on. Well, anytime you see a goaltender racing after a loose puck, you always hold your breath. And, Travis, that was a near collision, but it worked.
Yeah, I mean, it didn't look like he had a whole lot of time to get there, and, you know, was fortunate just to kind of get a stick onto it and get it to an angle where, you know, Sanza didn't really have a chance to shoot at much from the sideboards.
Faceoff is to the left of the St. Thomas goaltender. Under 5 minutes to go here in the first period. 1-0, Acadia is leading on the goal by Owens. Centering pass by Dietrich. Missed everybody and slides back into the Axemen zone, and Morin will come back to pick it up in behind the Acadia goal. Clark around the net. Comes out on the right side. Banks it on the boards, and Dietrich will redirect it in behind the St. Thomas net. Collier, the goaltender, out, played it around the boards, kept in by Clark. Now a pass by Dietrich off a stick, and back the other way goes Bonneau. Tried to move it ahead. Play is broken up, and Clark sends it left side to Dietrich. Dietrich's up on the line, and he dropped it off. He had Owens coming in but didn't see him. Back the other way go the Tommies. Shermidiev has the puck right side. In, shoots, and it's stopped by Mosier. Deflects way up in the air, and Owens comes back, corrals the puck, and skates out on the left side. Quick pass ahead for Dietrich, just a little out of his reach. Hennigan will play it on the left side. Shermidiev now sending it ahead. And the Tommies will try to work out. Cameron gets to center and backhands it in behind the Acadia net. Kurseba around the goal, sends it ahead to McElraith. McElraith took his time handling it there and didn't see some players on that far side. The puck goes down the ice right to Mosier. And he is going to hang on to get a faceoff in the Axemen zone. 3:33 on the clock to play here in period number one. The only goal in this first period, a power play goal scored by Christopher Owens. The Axemen 1-for-2 with a man advantage here in the first period. The Tommies have not had a power play yet in this game. Far side, Jezegu along the boards. Battles with Cameron. Cameron works the puck toward the corner. Now it's broken up. And Brown sends it ahead, and Jezegu missed it. Tommy's waiting at center to fire it right back in. Mosier gives it to Eckelman. And Eckelman with lots of time. The Tommies decided to make a change, so Eckelman, playing defense tonight, moves up the left side and dumps it around the boards. Poulin gets it ahead. Gallant takes a pass on the right side. In over the Axemen line. Moves it ahead, and the play broken up, and the Axemen now going to move up the ice. Quickly, Jezegu on the left side. Over the St. Thomas line, he has three other players, tries to send it back, but it's intercepted, and the Tommies back the other way. Bernier has it on the right side. He has a man going to the net, shot on the way, stopped by Mosier, and he steers the puck nicely to the far boards. No rebound sitting there, and the Axemen are going to move to center. McElraith quickly up over the line. McElraith dropping it off. Ward has it. Ward forced to the right side, then he's poke-checked, and St. Thomas gathering control. The puck out to center. Taken by Morehouse, and he'll roll it into the Acadia zone. St. Thomas here making some very quick changes. Schwenard behind his net, pushes it over to Gibbons. And Gibbons will work back behind the net. Taken down, and a St. Thomas penalty coming up. So the Axemen are going to get their third power play of the period. Their only goal with a man advantage. Mosier goes to the bench for the extra attacker. Morin slides it ahead. Helas shoots, and it goes through the crease out the other side. Picked up by Benoit, and the penalty call with 1:55 on the clock is made. And so the Axemen will put their power play unit back to work here, leading 1-0. For an exhibition game, and as much as there was rust in the first few minutes, Acadia hasn't played a bad game here.
No, I think, a pretty good start. Obviously, playing a team like St. Thomas, they do a pretty good job of trapping things up through the middle. And, I think at times probably, maybe forcing some passes, through the neutral zone that aren't there. But overall, I think it'll be pretty happy for the, first game back here in a month.
Puck dumped down the ice by St. Thomas, so the Axemen will set up behind the net. Owens with the puck. And the defenseman quickly to center with a right wing pass to Helas. And Helas moves to the corner, fires it around the boards, and Morin has it. Morin sends it down low to Ward. Ward will leave it for Morin at the left point. Goes cross ice to Owens, and he'll switch up with Morin. Owens sending it toward the goal, blocked in front, gets it back at the point, fakes a shot, now gives it to Clark. Clark to the goal line, back to Owens, cross ice. Morin shoots, and a toe save made by Collier. Clark, bottom half of the left wing circle with a pass that went off a skate into the corner. Trombley is there, and the veteran defenseman fires it back to the Acadia line. Owens on it quickly. Under a minute to go in the opening period. The Axemen with a man advantage leading 1-0 here late in the first frame, and they'll move out. Ward has it at center with a left wing pass to Helas. Just glides in over the line. He'll play it back to Morin. Morin with a shot toward the net. Deflected just wide of the goal on the near side. Tommies get control and send it down the ice. Axemen going to send out another power play unit here. Gibbons will give them time to set up. Chance for one more rush here with under 30 seconds to go in the period. Quickly, Kurseba on the left side. Worked it ahead for Gaynor. Gaynor tried to drop it off. Kurseba was in a collision with Morehouse back at center. And so the puck goes down the ice. Back for it, Jezegu. Jezegu sends it ahead to Schwenard quickly down the left side. Schwenard in, shoots, and it went off a stick and deflects high and well wide of the goal. 3 seconds to go in the period. Jezegu sends in front, puck to the point, and Kurseba ran out of time as the buzzer sounds. And Gibbons, just before that, had missed in a one-timer. And so the Axemen will open up the second period with a very short 4-second power play. But all in all, for 20 minutes, back after 4 weeks off, Travis, not a bad effort here.
No, I mean, I think, you'd be happy just to kind of get back into the swing of things here and come out with a 1-0 lead after the first and do a pretty good job. I thought defensively didn't give up a whole lot and created a few chances.
All right, one period in the books here tonight. It's a 1-0 Axemen lead after 20 minutes at Acadia Arena, Wolfville. Welcome back to Acadia Arena in Wolfville. The whole team is coming back on the ice here for period number two. The Axemen lead the St. Thomas Tommies by a score of 1-0. It's the first exhibition game of the second half for both of these teams. Christopher Owens scoring for Acadia on a power play at 9:15. Jonathan LaBerge and Michael Ward picking up assists. Shots in the first period, 11 by Acadia, 7 for St. Thomas. Tommies did not have a power play in the opening period. The Axemen were 1-for-2 and are actually on their third power play with just 4 seconds remaining and a penalty to Scott. So we get ready for period number two, and the Axemen off the draw. Control the puck, and Ward gets it to Beaton. The penalty to St. Thomas is over. And so now the Axemen are officially 1-for-3 with a man advantage tonight. Morehouse up over the line with a slap shot, fired it high and wide. The rebound, nice stop by Mosier, sliding across. Puck in the Axemen zone. Morehouse and Ward bumping along the boards deep in the Acadia zone. Gibbons hits his man along the boards, and now Clark for the Axemen, getting it ahead to Gibbons, in his skates, can't find it, far side, Morehouse turns, and a shot deflects in behind the net. Gibbons battling there, takes his man down, and the Axemen are going to pick up their first penalty of the night, and so the St. Thomas Tommies will get the man advantage. St. Thomas hockey team did not have a power play in the opening period. I mentioned in the first period that St. Thomas is had a half-decent start to the season. It's a rebuilding year with a brand-new head coach. The St. Thomas power play in the first half of the season is an area, obviously, that hasn't been too bad. 17.3% efficiency. They've scored 14 goals and 81 opportunities. Play just underway, and the puck goes into the Axemen zone. Shemityev on it quickly, but he got into traffic and couldn't get the backhander. Owens couldn't clear the zone as he tried to lob it down the ice. Tommies keep it in and try to get things set up, and they're having a difficult time right now. The Axemen broke it up, but now Sanza with it. He'll send it back to Andrasopoulos. 1-0 Acadia early here in the second. St. Thomas with its first power play. An opportunity far side, main shoots, and it's just directed wide at the side of the goal. And the puck now gets caught up in the mesh. And so we get a little bit of trash talk at the side of the Acadia net. The Axemen penalty killing in the first half of the season. Excellent for this Axemen hockey team. Giving up just 9 power play goals in the first half. And very close to a 90% effective percentage here for this Axemen hockey team. So definitely one of the strengths. The penalty killing of the Acadia Axemen in the first half. Minute 15 to go on the penalty to Gibbons. And the Tommies will start at their own line. And quickly, Bonneau comes out to center with a right wing pass for Scott. Off his stick into the corner. He's steered to the boards by Kersiba. And a chance for the Axemen to send it down the ice. And they do as Bona sails it through the air. Pulling in behind the St. Thomas net. We'll give it to Bonneau. And he'll make his way up the right side to center to the Acadia blue line. And the red shirts are waiting. And now the puck up on the right side. And Schwenard in after it. Up on the right side. Shoots. Stopped by Collier. And he hangs onto it. And Travis, I know we talked about it in our radio broadcast many times in the first half. But number 14 for Acadia, arguably one of the fastest skaters in the conference.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, his first couple steps are real explosive. And he's able to create a lot of separation with that. And, you know, especially on this ice surface, if he gets a step on you, it's pretty tough to catch up to him, that's for sure.
Well, we've certainly seen some goals scored in the first half by the rookie forward, and all a result of his foot speed out on the ice. Andrasopoulos plays it up on the right side. The puck brought in. And the Tommies try to set up with just 20 seconds to go on the man advantage, but they're not going to have much luck here. Although Jezegu doesn't get it out, Hennigan able to keep it in. Puck in the corner. He gets a pass out at the left point. Gives it to Gallant. Gallant looking toward the net. Now walks toward the net. Forced behind the goal. Looks out front. Gives it to Hennigan. Shot on the way. Stopped by Mosier. And the rebound is knocked outside the line. And Gibbons out of the box. And the Tommies fail to score with their first man advantage of the night. 1-0 Acadia. 3 minutes played here in period number two. Puck at center. And Gallant will lift it high in the air, and it bounces into the Axemen zone. Tommy's changing up. Michael Ward back behind the Axemen goal with it. And he has lots of time. Around the net goes Gehrman. Gives it back to Ward. Return pass for Gehrman out of his reach down the ice. It's going to be an icing call against the Acadia Axemen. So the Axemen here, probably like St. Thomas, really haven't had a big opportunity to get a lot of practices in. Most of the players, I think, required to be back on, what, the 27th or 28th, Travis?
Yeah, I think guys are back 27th, skated the 28th, 29th. So, we were out for a quick little skate this morning. So, three times out here, and, guys, I think they're starting to slowly probably get their game legs back under them.
Puck up on the right side. Tommy's bringing in, but Owen's going to break up the play easily on the far side, and he's able to lob it just inside the St. Thomas line. Trombley on it and fires it around the boards, then takes a hit. Cameron has it at center, goes cross-ice to Shermidiev. He'll play it in on the far side, but it goes offside. He just made a little move inside the blue line. Some good checking there by the Axemen, and that forced the play to go offside. We played 3 minutes and 45 seconds here in the second period. The Axemen leading 1-0. Faceoff outside the Axemen line, controlled by St. Thomas, and the puck is dumped in behind the Acadia net. Gibbons with lots of room on the right side, plays it through the middle. Lead pass was out of the reach of Beaton, and the puck comes back into the Axemen zone. Gibbons will go cross ice. And Morin, his pass hit the linesman's skate, and the Tommies able to dump it back into the zone. Gibbons taking his time in behind the Acadia net. And Gibbons will start out. And the Tommies don't put any deep pressure on. Let the Axemen skate out. Beaton gets the puck over the line. Now he's going to dump it behind the net. Poulin sends it around, and waiting for it left point is Morin with a shot that deflects wide of the goal. Dietrich with a shot, and it goes behind the net around the boards. Clark playing it to Beaton in the corner. Beaton gives it to Clark. Clark, side of the net to Dietrich, comes out in front, shoots, stopped by Collier. The rebound, and the blue paint finally covered up by Collier, and he will get a face-off in the St. Thomas zone. In some respects, probably a good team for the Axemen to start the second half in terms of an exhibition play, because St. Thomas is just a hard-working team, and they'll get you into that work ethic pretty quick.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, they're a pretty, they're a simple team. They keep things simple, and they work hard, and, that's in most ways probably what you want to see. Early in your exhibition season, it forces guys to, make good decisions with the puck and work hard, and above all, that's really what you want when you're just coming back off a long layoff.
Puck fired through the middle by the Tommies. Morehouse pass didn't connect out at center with Gallant. Goes down the ice, and this will be icing. We play just over 5 minutes here in the second period. The Acadia Axemen will play an exhibition game Monday afternoon at 4 o'clock in Berwick against the St. of X Axemen to wrap up their exhibition start to the second half. And then the real deal will start a week from tonight, January 6th. The Axemen host Moncton here in Wolfville. Eckelman has the puck. He's been playing defense tonight as the Axemen experiment with working a forward back on the blue line with all the injuries they had in the first half. And the puck goes down the ice, and Kursiva hit his man in front of the Acadia bench. And it was Morehouse, and now they have words with each other, and the St. Thomas bench was hollering for a penalty. Not sure what happened between Kursiva and Morehouse, but they both went down, and then as Morehouse got up, he went over and exchanged unpleasantries with the Acadia defenseman, Kursiba. And so we're going to get some, what will probably be some offsetting penalties here. Morehouse goes to the box for St. Thomas, Kursiba for Acadia. 5.5 minutes into the second period. And this big ice surface, we'll see a little bit of extra room, I would think, with offsetting penalties, probably some 4-on-4 hockey here. Face off in the Acadia zone. We'll actually play 5-on-5, so coincidentals handed out here. Gaynor will take the faceoff for the Axemen against McDonald. And Gaynor is waved out, so Jezegu will step in. And off the draw, Tommy's control. Sanza sends it out in front. Play broken up. Puck to the point. Trombley sends it to the corner. Ward is there for Acadia. And Ward will play it behind the net. Over to Owens. Owens leaves it behind the goal for Ward. 1-0 Axemen as we approach the 6-minute mark of period two. Gaynor makes his way up the right side and dumps the puck into the St. Thomas zone. The goaltender Collier steers it around the boards. Kept in by Gaynor. And Brown will work along the boards. Brown gets to the corner, hit by Trombley. Trombley only played 7 games in the first half, a veteran defenseman, 5 years. Out there battling, and the Tommies able to clear the puck to center, and Ward's going to back up into the Acadia zone. Ward giving it to Owens. Quick pass up on the right side to Jezegu. Jezegu looks toward the net, gets to the goal line, stops in the corner, and Jezegu has Trombley behind him. Jezegu pulls away, works toward the net, and a weak shot that goes well wide of the goal. Bonneau on the far side, steered off the puck, and the Axemen take over. Owens out at center. Banks it off the boards to McIntyre, who will play it to the corner. McElraith centering pass, and it was behind German, who was covered in front of the St. Thomas net. Puck in the corner. Main takes a bump from McElraith. Main goes behind the St. Thomas net. Plays it around left side to Bonneau. Long right wing pass off an Acadia stick down the ice. Puck to the corner. McIntyre takes a little bump. Reich is there. And they battle on the far side of the Axemen zone. Tommies get control. Scott, not a lot of room to move on the right wing boards. Trying to find somewhere to go with it, and he won't. The Axemen break it up, and German's out on the right side to center. German over the line sends a shot that goes behind the St. Thomas net. Waiting at the far side, Dietrich, who plays it back behind the goal. And now the Tommies will clear it off the boards down the ice. And this will be an icing call. The shots in the game, 14 for Acadia and 9 for the St. Thomas Tommies. It's certainly not been a busy night for either goaltender. Quite a few of the shots have been from outside. Collier's been the busier. He faced some power play shots in the first period. And if not for the power play time, these shots would be even less here. 12:13 to go in the second period. And the Axemen will stay with Clark and Beaton, Dietrich, Eckelman, and Owens. Off the faceoff, Eckelman along the blue line gives it to Dietrich, and he's forced to play it to the corner. And Clark pinned up along the boards by Bernier, one of two newcomers to the St. Thomas team at the Christmas break. Puck in behind the net, and the St. Thomas defenseman fell. That allowed Clark to get to the puck in the corner. Now Beaton is there trying to dig it free. Poulin goes around the St. Thomas net. He'll leave it for Bernier out of his reach. After it is Clark. He'll shovel it to the corner. Beaton was there looking for it. Dietrich is there to help out. And Dietrich in the corner. Again, not a lot of room to move. Leaves it for Clark. Plays the puck back to the point. Owens has it. His pass off a stick into the corner. Clark works it behind the net to Beaton. Dietrich. Fires side with a high shot. Collier the stop. And he hangs on. So the Axemen do a good job along the boards, Travis, but I think St. Thomas kind of shot themselves in the foot trying to work the puck out of the zone.
Yeah, I mean, a couple turnovers there, but, you know, a good job of keeping that pressure on and, you know, end result getting a couple, you know, pretty decent scoring chances out of it.
Face off in the St. Thomas zone, still 1-0 Acadia. Ward at the point, slap shot, blocker save by Collier, puck in the corner. And the Tommies with a chance to clear, and they do not. The Axemen here have hemmed them in here in the last couple of shifts. Collier out of his net, steers it to the boards, to the point. Morin with it. Fires a pass over to Schwenard. Whips it back to Ward. Ward along the blue line. Gives it to Schwenard into the circle. Centering pass off a stick. Bona was kind of gliding through the slot. Bona behind the net. Works to the left wing corner. Now we'll play it around on the opposite side for Schwenard, who takes a bump from Hennigan. Schwenard now redirects it over to the far boards, and Bona back to the blue line, and he's forced outside the line, and then the Axemen able to dump it back into the St. Thomas zone. Hennigan fires it off the boards, and the puck deflects into the St. Thomas bench. And out of play, 10 minutes and 27 seconds remaining. The Leon's Furniture March of Champions on ABR Radio will return on January the 6th when Moncton plays Acadia in Wolfville. And of course, you can hear the broadcast here as well as see it through the Acadia Athletics website. Gibbons playing it back to Kersiba. Over to Gaynor. Quick pass ahead for Jezegu off a stick into the corner. And the Axemen go to the attack once again. Jezegu steers it to the point. Kersiba misfired as he tried to one-time it. Puck through the middle, and Gibbons knocked it down. Skates it back into the right side. Gibbons to Brown. Centers through the crease. Nobody there. Kersiba waits far side. Scores! Paul Kersiba, about 4 feet off the left wing boards, waited for the puck to come around. He just wound up and one-timed it up high and beat Collier. And Travis, tonight it's the defense that are doing all the offense.
Yeah, I mean, I think we saw in the first half, you know, we got a real good contribution from our defensemen, and, you know, definitely nice to see that continue here to start the second half off. But that's been a real key for us this year, is those guys jumping up into the play and getting pucks to the net, and, you know, just a good job there by Kersiba of, you know, finding a loose puck and getting it on net. And, you know, like we always say, good things happen when you do that.
Paul Kersiba missed 9 games of the first half. Did not score a goal. One of just a handful of Axemen who didn't get a goal in the first half. A lot of the scoring has been spread out, but the Acadia defense scoring this year has almost tripled, and we still have half a season to play. The Axemen are going to be called here for icing. Jezegu picking up an assist, the goal coming at 10:04. And so the Axemen now with a 2-0 lead, 9:45 to play in the second period. And the Axemen have made a goaltending change. So Mosier comes out, and Peter DeSalvo goes in now to take over in the Acadia goal. And they'll split the goaltending duties here tonight in this exhibition game right after Christmas. Salvo has not been between the pipes in game action in quite some time, so we'll see how he reacts out there. Puck out at center, banked off the boards by McIntyre. He gets it inside the St. Thomas line. And on the far side, the puck battling for it along the goal line. Now McIntyre tries to bring it out front. Here's a shot on the way. It hits some legs in front. Another shot hit the goaltender. He didn't see that. Kersiba with another shot, and it's blocked. And the Axemen here, the last 5 or 6 shifts, have been in the St. Thomas zone. And the Tommies have really had a hard time making their way over center. Now they'll have an opportunity as Morehouse brings it in. Shoots, pad save to Salvo, and his first test is a good one. Morehouse behind the net, looking out front, takes a bump from Kersiba behind the Acadia net. Puck is fired out by everybody, and the Tommies are forced back into their own end. Hennigan, cross ice, Andrasopoulos, long left wing pass to Cameron. He'll bring it in, winds up, slap shot low and wide, off the boards, Lively. And the Axemen are just able to push it out to center. Cameron back to Andrasopoulos. Pass ahead, Shremidiev couldn't pick it up cleanly. And Dietrich will just work it over the St. Thomas line. Gets it back at the blue line. Dumps it around the boards. Hennigan has it. Long left wing pass out to the Acadia line. And Cameron gets by Owens. Cameron trying to cut to the net. Knocked to the ice by Owens. Sansa couldn't come up with the puck to come in and help out his forward. And now Clark is just going to lob it out at center. Andrasopoulos gets by one man, brings it in left side, has a man going to the net. It's Sansa. Andrasopoulos tried to drop it off, and Owens read that play nicely and picked up the pass. And the Axemen defenseman whips the puck ahead to Beaton, and Beaton will bounce it into the left wing corner. Dietrich sends a cross crease, nobody there, and the Tommies now with a chance to move it out. Puck ahead to Bonneau, makes a move. Coming in is McDonald, shoots, blocker save, rebound into the crease, taken away by Ward. And DeSalvo's faced a couple of shots here since he came in to take over. Trombley at the left point, Wine shoots, blocked by Schwenard, and the puck deflects back to the St. Thomas line. 7:20 to go in the second period, and the Axemen with a 2-0 lead, long pass for Bonneau, out of his reach, and it's icing against the St. Thomas Tommies. Well, just until the last two shifts, the Axemen, Travis, for about probably a 7 or 8 minute period, really hemmed St. Thomas into their own end with a lot of the play on the perimeter.
Yeah, I mean, good job of getting pucks in deep and getting some pressure in on their D and forcing some turnovers. But, you know, as you said, the last couple shifts, I think St. Thomas kind of responded and, you know, had a couple real good chances there. And DeSalvo's made a couple real big saves here since he's come in.
Off the faceoff, puck at the point. Morin banks it off the backboards. Brown sends it out in front. There was nobody there. And it comes to center. And then Ward misfired on a pass. Bonneau brings it in for St. Thomas to the slot. Backhander blocked by Morin. The rebound, side of the net, off the outside of the goalpost. And the Axemen get lucky. Shot on the way. It deflects wide of the goal. And Morin with it for Acadia. Falls as he tried to clear it ahead. And now the Axemen get control. And Brown sends it ahead to Jezegu, just out of his reach. Hustling back into his own end. Bonneau with the puck on the near side as Bernier had fired it around the boards. Main with it. Cross ice, Bonneau took it in the skates and it goes out to center. And Gaynor's going to backhand it into the St. Thomas zone. Long pass out to the middle. Broken up by the Axemen. And Morin gets it ahead to Gaynor. Deflects into the Acadia bench. Out of play. Shots on goal, 18-11 favoring Acadia. Now with 6:20 to play here in the second period, the Axemen on goals by Christopher Owens in the first and Paul Kersiba here in the second have a 2-0 lead. Off the faceoff, Schwenard bouncing it to the St. Thomas line. And now Poulin sends it ahead. It deflects into the Acadia zone. DeSalvo going to work it in to the corner along the board. Schwenard battling with Morehouse. Helis around the net. And Helis trying to find some space. He's not going to get it. Takes a hit, and the linesman went down along with Helis. Puck is brought back in. And Helis hit his man on the far side, just inside the blue line, and Gallant didn't like it, and now he's going to go off. Puck in the corner, and Gibbons. Puck comes out in front. Slap shot, and it's blocked by Kersiba. Puck rolls out to center, and back for it is Bernier. Plays it to the middle. Left wing pass for Poulin, the defenseman, who was caught up at the Acadia blue line. Can't handle the pass, and Bona wraps it off the boards to center. Bernier backing up. He'll go cross ice. Gibbons easily breaks up the play. Gets it ahead to Helis, and Helis will bring it in over the St. Thomas line with a shot off a stick to the corner. And the puck deflects to the near boards. Gibbons faked that he was going to shoot. Now moves slowly down, sends it into the crease, and McIntyre couldn't get a stick on it. Puck to the point. Owens gives it to McIlwraith. McIlwraith, puck come back to Gibbons with a shot, blocker save in traffic, and St. Thomas will ice the puck here and get a whistle with under 5 minutes to play here in the second. One notable loss here in the second period is forward Jonathan LaBerge. Travis, any report on him in the intermission?
Yeah, it was just, I think he got a puck in the hand and, you know, was just kind of having trouble gripping his stick, but, you know, was a little worried originally there where he took that hit in the first period, but it was nothing to do with that. It was just kind of a, you know, kind of a freak thing, taking a puck in the hand, but I think, you know, it doesn't look like it's anything too serious.
Not really an important game to force him out here.
No, exactly. I mean, he's just having a little trouble gripping his stick and stuff, and I mean, there's really no point, obviously, especially with the injury situation we had in the first half. You don't want to, you know, force anything in a game like this and lose a guy for an extended period of time.
Puck around the boards. Clark waiting for it on the near side. The Axemen actually dressed an extra player tonight. Because it's an exhibition game, allowed to do that. Shermidiev coming to center. Plays it in on the left side, around the boards. DeSalvo will stop it there for Owens. 4.5 minutes to go in the second. The Axemen 2, St. Thomas nothing. Owens, who opened up the scoring in the first period, will work the puck around the boards in the St. Thomas zone. Clark on the far side. Plays it down low to Dietrich, but it was out of his reach. Tommies get control, and Bonneau picks up a pass on the left side. Fires it through the middle, and it's picked up by Reich. And then he's pushed off the puck by Eckelman, who didn't kind of slowed him up, and Reich didn't like it very much. Hennigan at center, big defenseman, fires a pass to the middle, went off Jezegu's stick. Owens will bank it off the boards to Jezegu, and he sends a pass ahead to Brown on the right side. Brown into the St. Thomas zone. Centers in front through the crease, and Gaynor couldn't get to it. Puck on the far side, kept in by Moore. Now Gaynor down into the corner. Gaynor below the goal line. Plays it behind the net to Brown. Centering pass, quick shot right on. Stopped by Collier as Ward one-timed it. What a heads-up play by Brown to find Ward. Sneaking into the right side, Travis. And Collier, I think, is a little bit lucky there. That puck just hit him.
Yeah, I mean, he obviously got across and did get a piece of it. But, yeah, I think that was more a case of, Ward just kind of misfiring on where he wanted to put that. And, unfortunately, just kind of caught the pad.
3:34 remaining in the second. The Axemen, 20 shots on goal, have certainly been the better team here tonight, the better scoring opportunities. Ward sends it, scores! An innocent shot that he almost lobbed, if you will, toward the net from the blue line, and it seemed to dip. And I don't know, Travis, if somebody got a stick on it or it just beat the goaltender cleanly.
Yeah, I think Bona kind of knocked that down as he was coming through the slot there. Nice little deflection to kind of drop that puck down, and no real chance there for Collier on that one.
So the Axemen, with their second straight even strength goal here in the second, have built up a 3-0 lead. And off the faceoff, the puck goes into the St. Thomas zone, and Trombley's back for it. Main sending it around on the right side. Gallant, his pass was not effective. He misfired, and now it deflects. Bona gets the goal for the Axemen. Not officially a defenseman tonight, so we can finally say a forward has scored here, although Bona certainly came into Acadia as a defenseman. But Ward gets the assist. 16:30 is the time of the goal, and it's 3-0 Acadia. Just over 3 minutes to play in the second period. Gurman dumps the puck over the St. Thomas line. After it, quickly McIntyre, and his centering pass was blocked by Main, and the Tommies able to clear it out. Cameron has it on the right side, trying to work toward the Acadia net, and his pass knocked down by Kersiba. Kept in on the near side. Sanza just get out of the way of a hit from Gurman. Gibbons carries out for Acadia. Gibbons up over the St. Thomas line, swings right side, and he's forced to dump it low around the boards. Behind the net is McIntyre. Pushed off the puck, but he stays with it. He and McElraith battling in the near corner. And now Poulin with it will steer it to the far boards, and Owens works it back into the corner. Poulin sends it behind the net, and Bernier has it. Bernier with room on the left side, gets to center over the Axemen line. St. Thomas have not spent a lot of time in the Axemen zone tonight, with just 11 shots on goal. Gibbons behind the Acadia net, giving it to Owens, plays it up on the boards, and the Axemen move over the line. Beaton has the puck in his skates, couldn't find it now, dishes it off right side for Clark. He'll play it behind the net for Dietrich. For Clark, back to Dietrich on the right wing boards. A little give and go. Dietrich trying to find room and outlet that puck. He'll leave it for Clark. Puck into the corner for Beaton. Gives it to Clark. Along the goal line, sends out in front, and the pass is blocked, and the Tommies move out to center. Bono on the left side. Over the Axemen line, into the circle. Centering pass that went off Owen's stick, wide of the goal. Far side, Owens. Passes it ahead to Dietrich. And Dietrich gives it to Eckelman, who joined. Eckelman in with a shot, low and wide. Goes behind the net. Eckelman giving it to Jezegu, firing it to the point for Clark. And Clark now will dump it in behind the net. 1:13 remaining in period number two. The Axemen 3-0. Owens moves it over the St. Thomas line. Hennigan will pick it up. Backhands a pass out to Gallant. Wraps it off the glass into the Axemen zone. Quickly back is Brown, and Brown gives it to Owens. Quick pass on the right side to Jezegu, taken away by Hennigan and dumped in to salvo the goaltender. Gives it to Owens, plays it around the boards, kept in by St. Thomas. But now the Axemen get control, and Jezegu takes a pass. He'll fire one over on the left side for Brown, and he couldn't control it. He knocked it down. Gaynor has it on the near side, bounces it toward the corner. And now the Tommies get it out to center. Ward firing a pass over to Morin, to Jezegu, and he steers it down the ice right to the St. Thomas goaltender. Andrusopoulos now in the corner, takes a bump from Bona, who scored Acadia's last goal. Tommy's clear around the boards, and Morehouse in over the Axemen line. Nobody there with him. Four red shirts, and he had nowhere to go. Puck goes ahead to Bona on the right side. Bona winds up, and the buzzer sounds to end period number two. So the Axemen, with a couple of even strength goals in that middle period, have extended their lead. It's 3-0 after 40 minutes of play. You're listening to Acadia Axemen Hockey. And welcome back to Acadia Arena in Wolfville. Exhibition hockey here at Atlantic University Sport between the Axemen and the St. Thomas Tommies. My name is Len Hawley. Hope you're enjoying the game. It's 3-0 Acadia after two periods of play. One goal in the first period. Defenseman Christopher Owens without a power play goal midway through. And then in the second period, Paul Kersiba scored an even strength goal at 10:04. And Graham Bona at 16:30. Also an even strength goal to make it 3-0. The shots in the second period very indicative of the territorial play, 11-4 favoring Acadia. The road shooting St. Thomas 22-11 on the night. Tommy's 0-1 with a man advantage. Acadia is 1-3. Both teams at full strength, and the third period is underway with the Axemen controlling as they have for much of the night. Puck on the left side, and Dietrich will bounce it into the St. Thomas zone. Poulin working it around the boards. Cut off by Clark. Sent it to the point, but it went by Kersiba. Down the ice, and DeSalvo way out of his net to play it up on the boards. Cameron for St. Thomas. Nowhere to go, and it's taken away from him by Gibbons at the Acadia line. Gibbons down the left side. Cuts to the net. Centers it in front and out of the reach of Beaton, who is just in front of the crease. Beaton in the right wing corner. Takes a bump. Leaves the puck for Dietrich. And Dietrich plays it to the point, and it goes by Gibbons out to center. And Kersiba will just flutter it back into the St. Thomas zone. The Axemen make some changes. Poulin with a long pass off the stick of Morehouse into the Acadia zone. Morin plays it up to Brown. Brown through the middle with a nice little pass to McIntyre. McIntyre gives it to McElraith, who couldn't get a shot away and then took a hit. McIntyre in behind the goal. Squeezed off the puck by Hennigan. Played deep on the St. Thomas zone, and now the Tommies with a chance. Andrusopoulos works it by the Acadia defenseman Owens down the ice. Out of his net, DeSalvo, who came in the second period. The goaltending being split in half here tonight. Long shot that stopped by Collier off McIntyre. And DeSalvo faced a couple of St. Thomas shots in his first couple of minutes of play, and had to make a couple of nice stops. Chouinard brings the puck in on the left side. Bona going to that, drops it off. McElraith shoots. Blocker saved by Collier, who was down on his knees. And now the Tommies, Reich coming out to center. His pass through the middle off Scott's stick and to the net, scores! DeSalvo misplayed the puck, and the puck slid outside the blue paint, and the St. Thomas player just got a stick on it, Scott, and slid it underneath the Acadia goaltender to make it a 3-1 game. Just after I had mentioned, DeSalvo made a couple of tough stops when he first came in midway through the second. That was an easy one, Travis. And you know what? I guess a guy who hasn't played a competitive game in almost 2 months, you got to give him a little bit of slack.
Yeah, I mean, just, you know, unfortunate little bounce there. It was just trying to cover that puck up and just sort of slipped away from him, and you know, just left an easy little tap in there for the St. Thomas player.
So an unassisted goal for the St. Thomas Tommies, Jordan Scott, to make it a 3-1 game. We'll see now that St. Thomas has a goal if they can get something generated here, trailing by two early in the third. Ward for Acadia gives it to Eckelman, who's been playing defense tonight. Played a little bit of defense in junior, drops it off to Helas, backhand, went off some skates, and then Cameron picks it up for St. Thomas. And he'll play it ahead to Shermidiev on the right side. Shoots it in, DeSalvo the stop. And Jezegu with the rebound for Acadia, makes his way to center. Tried to play it to Helas, and Helas gives it back to Jezegu. Jezegu twisting and turning, now flying in with a shot up high was Brown, and the stop made by Collier. Brown twisting and turning in the corner, plays it side of the net, and Jezegu couldn't wrap it around. Tommies get it out to center. Gibbons has it for Acadia. Gibbons ahead to Jezegu, left side. Jezegu's pass through the legs of Brown. Tommies take over. Right wing pass for Gallant, too far, and an icing call against St. Thomas. 3 minutes and 15 seconds gone. The Axemen without the services of Jonathan LeBarge, who went down hurt in the first period and did not return. Joel Ridgway out of the lineup with a concussion, and Leo Jenner not expected back till late in the second half if all goes well. Owens dumping it wide to the St. Thomas net. Bernier Comes out on the near side with a right wing pass to Gallant. And he will backhand it down to the Acadia goal. And it hit the goalpost. And where is it? It's picked up by Cullen Morin. And DeSalvo right now is rattled in the Acadia goal. And the Tommies have picked up on it a little bit, I think, because they're just sending stuff toward the net. Puck at the point. Shot. Stop. Call your rebound. And he stopped that off Gaynor in tight. Well, this game has had some interesting things happen here in the opening minutes of the third period with the Axemen up 3-1. Reich from center shoots it in off a stick, and it goes out of play. And DeSalvo right now gets a little bump on the pads from Beaton. He's trying to settle his goaltender down. Puck was shot in toward him and beat him, bouncing toward the net, and obviously hit the post in behind, and he was very fortunate. Off the faceoff, the puck goes back into the St. Thomas zone. Andrasopoulos behind the goal, getting away from Beaton, forced to bank it on the boards to Bonneau. He'll give it to Reich at center, and then the play is broken up. Tommy's forced back. Andrasopoulos, left wing pass to Bonneau, and Ward just missed getting a piece of him. Bonneau, left side along the boards. Centers in front, shot on the way, stopped in front by DeSalvo off the big defenseman Hennigan. He'll play it out to the blue line. So DeSalvo is stopping these really impossible shots, but it's the easy ones coming toward the net he's having troubles with here tonight. Kurseba playing it back to Gibbons, ahead quickly to Beaton, left side to Dietrich. Dietrich winds, slap shot, stopped by Collier, bounces to the corner, puck to the point. Kurseba with a shot, low and wide. Gibbons waiting for it, right point, will slide it behind the net to Beaton. Beaton out front, and a quick shot by Clark. He didn't get a lot on it, and the puck went wide. Dietrich, left wing boards, looks toward the goal, shot, Collier down on his knees, and stops that one, and hangs on. I'm not so sure that the Axemen have done a great job of going to the net here tonight, Travis, but Collier's made a couple of stops up high down on his knees.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think, there's been really a lot of second chance opportunities. I think the odd time that, we have gotten good pressure to the net, that's kind of when a lot of our high-end chances have occurred. But, you got to give a bit of credit, I think, probably to St. Thomas. They're doing a pretty good job of keeping things to the outside. But, I mean, that's something definitely if you want to score goals against a team like this, you got to do a real good job of getting that presence in front of the net and getting those second chances.
Puck out at center ice, and Sanza. Penalty coming up to Acadia. Cameron turns it over to McElraith. The call's coming up, and it's going to be a holding call against McElraith here, 5.5 minutes into the third period. And the Acadia Axemen with a 3-1 lead will now find themselves shorthanded for the second time tonight. The Tommies had a power play, their only one in the second period, and failed to score on it. And now trailing 3-1 here in the third period, a great opportunity to make this interesting. Off the faceoff, puck behind the Acadia net. Now it comes to the near boards, and Gaynor will fire it off the boards and down the ice. Collier steers it to Bernier. Bernier will play it back behind the net. And now Poulin will skate it out of the zone. Poulin with a left wing pass, brought in by Bernier, but Morehouse, the newcomer to the Tommies, just in ahead of the play. And an offside call against St. Thomas. Mentioned Leo Jenner being out of the lineup for a while. He's actually not back at Acadia quite yet. Spending some time in Edmonton for good reason. Travis's brother Boone is member of the Canadian World Junior team.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, unfortunate injury, but I mean, I guess there's a silver lining to it. It's probably getting, to get out there and see that in person. And I know Boone's played real well here so far, and I'm sure Leo and the family are real excited to be there.
Canada 3-0 will play the U.S. How about the U.S. losing to the Czech Republic today? The U.S., one of the favorite teams, 1-2, and they play Canada tomorrow night. Poulin, cross ice, as the Tommies try to set up side of the net. Gallant will steer it back right point. Poulin has it. Poulin back to Gallant. Gallant goes cross ice, chance for Bernier, and he bobbled it off the end of his stick. Now he fires a pass to Poulin. Shot down low off the backboards, and it comes out to Helas, and the Axemen will move to center. Helas with a little pass through the middle. He tried to hit Clark, but it was knocked down nicely by Poulin. Morehouse brings it in over the line, dropping it off to Bonneau. Bonneau toward the net with a pass that's stopped by the defenseman Ward. Chesigu finds the loose puck, and Chesigu takes his time, 30 seconds to go on the man advantage, and it's the Axemen here going to the offense, but Chesigu turns it over inside the St. Thomas line. Scott will bring it up right side. Scott to the corner, puts the brakes on, then got tied up in some traffic. Chesigu goes behind the net, gives it to the defense, and Kursiva has time, and he'll dump it down the ice. Just 8 seconds to go on the man advantage for St. Thomas. Acadia 3, the Tommies 1 here in the third period. Main takes a pass up the left side, cuts toward the net, and now he's forced to the corner. Beaton took it away, and his pass outlets to McElraith, ahead to Gaynor. Gaynor then had it poked off the end of his stick, and the Tommies bounce it out to center. Both teams at full strength. The Tommies 0-for-2. Beaton with a lead pass, tries to split the defense to the backhander. Stopped by the goaltender, and he'll hang on with it squeezed under the pads along the ice. A tough stop for him to make. And Justin Collier, the rookie goaltender, hangs on to keep his team within two here. 28-15 are the shots on goal favoring Acadia in this game. Just over 12 minutes to play in the third period, and the Axemen leading it 3-1. Off the draw, Tommy's control, Hennigan rifles it around the boards, and Cameron just redirects it into the Acadia zone. And this is going to be icing called against the St. Thomas Tommies. The Acadia Axemen will play the St. FX X-Men Monday afternoon at 4 o'clock in Berwick at the Kings Mutual Century Center. Another exhibition game as they tune up for the second half. Game time, 4 o'clock. Tickets at the Apple Dome all weekend from Berwick Minor Hockey members, and they will be sold at the door Monday. Off the faceoff, quick shot by McIntyre. He comes to the near boards and is knocked to the ice. Puck bouncing around. And now Sanza gets it out to center, and Gibbons will fire it back to Owens. Owens, who opened the scoring for Acadia midway through the first, gives it to Gibbons, and he'll pass it up left side to Dietrich, and he'll bounce it into the corner. Hennigan is there. McElraith with him. They bump along the boards. Now Hennigan steers it around. Far side, Owens after the puck. And he'll work it in behind the net. McElraith centering pass out to the slot. Knocked away by Cameron. And Cameron for St. Thomas can't clear the zone. Dietrich has it left wing boards. Shoots it up high off Collier's glove. And deflects out the other side. Now Sanza on it quickly. Left side over the Axemen line. Drops it off to Cameron. Shot on the way off the outside of the post. Far side, Brown knocks Morehouse off the puck, and it's bounced out to center. Hit somebody at the Acadia bench, so we'll get a stoppage in play. 11 minutes to play here in the third period. Mentioned Acadia's exhibition game on Monday in Berwick. Their regular season opens for the second half a week from tonight, Friday, January 6th. The Moncton Aigle Blue play in Wolfville at 7 o'clock. Helis with a puck on the right side. Long pass out to Bona, picks it up. That center drops it off. Eckelman in, shoots. Nice glove stop by Collier. Does the splits and takes it in the mitt. And hangs on to get a faceoff on the St. Thomas zone. Bona scored in the second period, and he dropped that puck off to Eckelman, who's been playing defense tonight. The Axemen experimenting here with Eckelman to see how he'll do. And your thoughts, Travis, watching him play as a defenseman for the first time in university?
I think he's done a real good job. I mean, he's made some real good plays with the puck, and, you know, when he's had the opportunity, he's jumped up into the rush. And, I mean, I think for, you know, a guy who hasn't done it for, you know, a year or two for sure, he's looked real good back there.
Shot from Bona from well out. He's stopped by Collier, and he hangs on. Haystoff will stay in the St. Thomas zone. And the Axemen going to send out a new forward line here as Beaton comes out with Clark and Schwenard. And off the faceoff, Tommies get control, and Bernier. Puck is bounced down to the Acadia goal and now into the corner. Morin hits his man. Bambi has it, sends it toward the goal, and it bounces wide. Gallant to the far side, couldn't get it to the point. Now Clark, little right wing pass to Chouinard. Chouinard tried to return it to Clark. Now to Beaton, backhander, stopped by Collier, and he hangs on. They get a faceoff in the St. Thomas zone. Beaton has been a pleasant surprise. I know Darren Burns said that to me toward the end of the first half. Pleasant surprise for the Axemen program.
Yeah, I mean, I think coming in, you know, we knew he had some skill, and, you know, we're kind of almost a similar situation, I think, to Chris Owens last year. We weren't quite sure, you know, how he'd make the adjustment coming from Junior A. And, you know, I thought right off the start he was playing really well and, you know, maybe had a four or five game stretch there at the start of the year where, you know, he kind of maybe struggled a little bit. But, I mean, ever since probably game number four or five, I mean, he's been one of our top guys and, you know, he's a real good offensive player. And, you know, him and Clark have really started to gel and create some real good chemistry together.
Past the midway point of the third period. And an icing call here against Acadia. 9:42 to go in the third and the Axemen are leading by a score of 3-1. In support of the Acadia Phantom C team, on a green ticket, number
504-7897. Again, a green ticket, 504-7897.
Face off in the Axemen zone, puck in behind the goal. Ward will fire it up on the right side. Puck's lobbed through the middle on the end of stick. A Beaton goes in, partially on a break, and couldn't pull the trigger. Main got back to tie him up. And he couldn't pull the trigger on a shot. Beaton's been dangerous here tonight on several occasions, getting some chances. Scott in with a shot. Stop. DeSalvo bobbles it, but he's able to knock it away from the Acadia crease. And back goes Jezegu over center. Left side, Jezegu. Slowed up by Tremblay, and now there's going to be a penalty handed out here. And it's going to be a holding call against the fifth-year defenseman for St. Thomas. So with 9:12 to go in the third, the Axemen up by two. They'll get their fourth power play of the evening, 1-for-3 with a man advantage. Tremblay disagrees with the call. He'll go to the box for 2 minutes. And the Axemen send out their power play unit. Helis, Chouinard, Ward, Clark, and Owens parked back at the blue line. The Axemen win the draw. Clark to Owens, and he'll give it to Schwinnard, left side. Down low to Helis, walks toward the net, along the ice, and scores! The Axemen took just 9 seconds to cash in on the power play, and it was kind of a delayed reaction there to see if the puck had actually gone behind Collier, and it did, and Helis here for the Axemen restores the 3-goal lead here. Key to that there, Travis, is the faceoff win, and the Axemen have certainly improved in that area this season.
Yeah, I mean, that's been an area that, you know, we really needed, I think, to improve on, and we've been, you know, pretty good for the most part in that first half. And, I mean, when you start playing the top teams like UMB and, you know, teams like that, you know, puck possession is such a big part of the game, and if you can, you know, even just go 50% against them, I mean, it gives you that much of an advantage. You're not chasing the puck all day, and you know, you're not giving teams those chances to set up. And I think on our power play especially, it's been, you know, a huge difference so far this year and really lets you set up and not have to go back and break the puck out.
Cameron plays the puck behind the Axemen net. Casey Brown gives it to Gibbons. And Gibbons will play it behind the goal for Owens. Owens gives it back to Gibbons. 8:20 on the clock. 35-16, shots favor Acadia. And they're in control of this one, 4-1, although they've turned the puck over deep in their own end. The puck to the point. Poulin plays it off the backboards, bounces behind the net. Far side, Casey Brown knocks it off the boards, can't quite get it out. And Bernier took a hit from McElraith. McIntyre lifts the puck out to center. Bernier fires a pass ahead. Morehouse turned it over, but it's kept in by Gallant, sent toward the goal. Gibbons knocks his man down side of the goal, and Owens has control of it, and now a penalty coming up to Acadia. And so the Tommies will get their third power play of the night, trailing 4-1. Out of town tonight, UPEI, after two periods, leading Moncton by a score of 3-2. This is all exhibition play tonight. St. of X and St. Mary's, 2-2 after two periods. And after two periods, UNB is leading the University of Ottawa 5-0. Maine at the point. Gives it to Bonneau. Sends it down low. Albineau has control on the right wing boards. The St. Thomas power play has not connected here tonight. That's the third opportunity. Andrasopoulos knocked to the ice by Schwenard. Now Schwenard plays it back to Ward inside the Acadia line, and he'll send it down the ice. Main with control. Little pass ahead to Bonneau. Bonneau carries up over the line. Bonneau in with a shot, stopped by DeSalvo. Eckelman behind the net. Knocked off the puck, right to Main. Main sending it down low, gets a return pass. Now he'll whip it over to Andrasopoulos. Back to Main. Main shoots toward the goal, and it sails just wide. Colin Morin on the far side with an opportunity, and he'll lift the puck high in the air down the ice. And then out of his net is Collier, and he'll play it off the backboard, says Eckelman had gone down the ice looking for a loose puck. Main out of the St. Thomas zone to center. Little pass to Cameron, and a return pass to Main in the corner. Centering pass Dromidiev. Here's a one-timer on the stick, snaps in half from Sanza, who is in a pretty good spot. Puck sent down the ice into the St. Thomas zone, and Poulin behind the goal. 34 seconds to go on the man advantage. Pass through the middle, off a stick, and stopped by DeSalvo and steered into the corner. Dietrich will bank it off the glass, not out. Kept in by Bernier. Now Owens takes a bump, and the puck fired down the ice by the Axemen. So St. Thomas here not really able to get set up with the man advantage. Trailing 4-1 with under 6 minutes to play in the third period. Bernier takes a pass left side and brings it in. Shot on the way, pad save, rebound, scores! And it's Morehouse who fires it upstairs, and with 1 second to go on the penalty to Gaynor. And so the Tommies cut the lead in half. It's now 4-2 with 5:46 remaining. And the Tommies get a power play goal here tonight. Faceoff out at center, and McElraith on the draw. Axemen control. Ward back to Gibbons. Little pass ahead to McElraith, and he'll bounce it down into the corner. McIntyre after it. Plays it behind the net around to the near side, and Gallant whips a pass ahead to Morehouse. Morehouse knocked to the ice, gets it ahead to Main. And Main couldn't go by Ward. Banks it off the boards, and McElraith gets it outside the line. Tommies clear it right back in, and Gibbons will corral it behind the net and gives it to Ward left side. Tommies changing up. That allows Ward some time to move out on the left side, and he lifts it into the air down into the corner. McIntyre getting to it first, takes a bump from Tremblay. Bona is there, and Tremblay works the puck out to Reich with a left wing pass to Bonneau. Bonneau gets by Eckelman. Bonneau looks out front, centering pass, and it's picked off by Morin, and now deflects over the glass with 4:49 remaining in the third period, and the Axemen leading it 4-2 here. Well, Morehouse is a newcomer, came at the Christmas break for this St. Thomas team, and certainly has not looked at a place for this team tonight.
No, I mean, he's a guy, obviously, you know, was at St. Mary's a couple years ago, and he's a, you know, a hard-nosed guy who kind of plays that, you know, game, similar type of game to a guy like Sean Avery. I mean, he's always yapping and under guys' skin, but at the same time, I mean, he's got some skill, and he can put the puck in the net if he gets the chance, like he showed there.
High shot that DeSalvo gloves and hangs on to. Face off in the Axemen zone. Gaynor will take the draw. And the puck back into the corner. Eckelman didn't see it as it deflected high, and now he'll corral it and give it to Morin. Morin trying to find room, and he banks it off the boards. Andrasopoulos working it ahead, and Scott will slide it right down to the Acadia goaltender, and DeSalvo is going to cover up once again to get a faceoff in the Axemen zone. And now both teams will make some changes. A reminder again, the Axemen play St. Evex Monday afternoon at 4 o'clock in Berwick. Their final exhibition game before they open the regular season for the second half on Friday night next week, January 6th, The Moncton Igloblue will be in Wolfville. Puck in the corner and Clark with it behind the goal. Battling with Shermidiev. Clark sends it high in the air and it bounces out to center. And Bernier on it quickly. Twisting and turning, looking for somewhere to send it. Now he will left side to Cameron off the end of his stick. And Christopher Owens plays it over to Dietrich. And Dietrich high in the air. Bounces over to Clark, and Clark will wrist it into the St. Thomas zone. Puck to the point, Kursiva had to go off his skate out to center. On it is Poulin. Poulin brings it in for St. Thomas, drops it off Shermidiev. In traffic, couldn't hang on to it. Now DeSalvo will work it around Dietrich. Turns it over, Sanza played it down low. Kursiva able to get it out to center. Clark couldn't hang on to it, and back comes Morehouse. Morehouse cuts toward the Acadia net, couldn't get a shot. Steered to the boards by Owens. Poulin sends out in front, and Clark found it and banked it off the far boards out to center. 4-2 Acadia, 3:15 to go in the third period. DeSalvo sends it around the boards, kept in by Maine. Maine with a shot on the way, stopped by DeSalvo. The rebound sent toward the goal, stopped. DeSalvo quickly covers up at the side of the net, as St. Thomas here with a late push in this third period, trailing by two goals here, and certainly have sensed with DeSalvo in the net, bobbled a couple of pucks here, one that cost him a goal. Just kind of throwing everything they can toward the net here to create opportunities. 3:05 to go in the third period, and Reich will take the faceoff. And now the linesman over getting some repair work at the Acadia bench with one of the trainers, so we'll get a little delay here. And now we're set to go. McElraith will take the draw against Reich, and McElraith wins it. Gibbons goes behind the net. And Gibbons slowly out of the Axemen zone with a right wing pass off the end of the McIntyre stick. Collier behind the net, steers it into the corner. And Scott with the puck for St. Thomas ahead to Reich. Reich high pass to Bonneau, knocked down, brings it in left side, then over skates, and McElraith gets it out to center, and McIntyre knocked down at the St. Thomas line, and the puck is sent back into the Axemen zone. Bonneau gets to it first, steered to the boards by Ward. Bonneau has it on the far side, he'll play it to the point. High shot, and it's stopped by DeSalvo. And he hangs on to get a faceoff with 2:25 remaining in period number three. 35-22 are the shots on goal favoring Acadia in this one. Off the faceoff, Morin banks it off the glass, but it goes into the Acadia bench, so we'll get a stoppage in play. The face-off back in the Axemen zone. It'll come to the right of DeSalvo with 2:19 to play here in the third period. Gaynor will take the draw. And off the face-off, Tommy's control. And Cameron misfired on his shot. The Axemen come out. Morin has it up over the line with a wrist shot. Stopped by Collier, and he's going to hang on and get a face-off. And it's actually offside call here against the Axemen, so the faceoff will come outside the line. Heckelman has the puck on the near side, and he'll fire it into the right wing corner. Hennigan there takes a bump from Gaynor. Andrasopoulos behind the net. Puck out through the middle. Dumped over to Sanza on the near side, deep in the Axemen zone. Sanza in the corner, has Ekelman watching him, knocks him to the ice. Puck centered out in front, bobbled by DeSalvo, but he hangs on. Shemediev almost trying to bank that in off the back of the Acadia net minor, but he was wise to it and hangs on with a minute 41 remaining here in the third period. And the Axemen up by two. Quick shot, DeSalvo makes the glove stop, and they'll do the faceoff all over again in the Axemen zone. McElraith, who's taking quite a few faceoffs here in the third period. DeSalvo side of the net, works it up left side, and Bona plays through the middle for McElraith. McElraith back to Bona. Bona in with a shot, stopped by Collier, and he will hang on with 1:25 to go in the third period. They don't drop the puck fairly, so they'll do that all over again. Clark on the draw for Acadia. Puck into the corner. Bernier turned it over. Kept in at the point by Owens. Owens circling right wing boards. Nowhere to go, so he'll fire it down behind the net. Beaton couldn't come up with it. Now the puck ahead to Poulin at center. Poulin gives it to Bonneau, and he'll bounce it into the corner. Now the goaltender's going to go to the bench for the extra attacker. And so the Tommies now have the goaltender pull. Bonneau with a shot blocked in front. Beaton has it, and he's able to steer it out to center. Bernier backs up. 50 seconds to play. And Clark shoots it toward an empty net and missed. Bernier behind the goal. Plays it up on the left side for Bonneau. Bonneau passes ahead to Scott. Scott tries to get it to Morehouse off his stick to the corner. Morehouse will play it behind the net. On it there is Reich out front. Quick shot blocked in front, and Owens will steer it off the boards just into the St. Thomas zone. 23 seconds remaining in the third. 4-2 Acadia. Puck off a stick into the Axemen zone behind the net is Ward. Ward will steer it over to Owens, and Owens tried to get it out, and it deflects over the glass with 10 seconds remaining. And the Axemen will open up the second half here with a victory on home ice and exhibition play, and will work a little more of the turkey off on Monday afternoon against the St. FX Axemen at 4 o'clock. Tommies are going to leave their goaltender on the bench with the extra attacker, even though there's 10 seconds left to play here. Maine firing it in wide to the Acadia goal. Gibbons will chop it on the boards to the point. And Casey Brown is able to get it outside the line just as the buzzer sounds. And that is going to do it for the hockey game. The Acadia Axemen beat the St. Thomas Tommies 4-2. Don't forget, they'll play St. of X in Berwick Monday afternoon at 4 o'clock. Thanks for listening to Acadia Axemen Hockey.